Hi everybody, my name is Hannah. Welcome to my channel. So today's video I have been meaning to film for a very long time, like a couple of months. And the reason I haven't done it yet is because I was afraid of the havoc that doing this video will take on my shelves. So, but now that I've actually put it all together, it's not that bad. I think I was just making it up in my head. Anyways. This is all a long way of saying that, as per the title of this video, I'm here to talk about all the unfinished series that I have going on right now, which is basically all of them, because I'm really good at starting series, but very, very, very bad at actually finishing them. So, I have split this video into sections, so I'm gonna start off with the books that I know for sure I do not intend to finish the series, so even though I started it, it's like, it's not gonna happen, you know, and I'll talk about why that is. Hello! So, after I finished filming this, I realized that it was way too long to be one video, or at least, I don't want it to be one video, because I'd have to edit a massively long video. So, I'm gonna split it into two. So this first section is gonna be book series that I will not finish, and then book series that I'm not sure if I'm gonna finish. So that's this one. And then in the next video, I will talk about the book series that I know for sure I'm going to finish, as well as some book series that weren't really supposed to be series, but then the author decided to make it a series, and so how I feel about each of those. So the first book series that I know for sure I will not be finishing is a YA dystopian series, and that is the Shatter Me series by Tahir Amafi. This is like an OG booktube kind of series, well, I don't know if it's OG dystopian because I think Hunger Games takes that crown, but it's one of those that came like right around that time, and it was all the rage back in 2012, 2014, 15, I don't even know at this point. But I read Shatter Me, I can't remember now, like I think 3 years ago, 4 years ago, and I also read the novella right after Shatter Me, which I believe is Destroy Me, and I just could not get into it, and I've seen a lot of people talk about this series, and I think it was definitely a series that was, you know, you kind of had to read it at the time that it came out, because now I think it seems a little dated, and maybe that's just me, and maybe I'm not the right age for it anymore, maybe I was never the right age for it, but it just felt a little like it wasn't really doing anything new or interesting, at least I didn't think it was, and I was a little disappointed in it. I am, however, interested in reading Tahira's other books, because although I didn't love her writing in that series, but I didn't hate it, and I know some people really, really hate her writing and think it's like too lyrical or whatever, and I didn't really mind that so much. I really just kind of didn't care about any of the characters in Shatter Me at all, and so yeah, but I know she's come out with a few other series and a contemporary novel, which I do want to read that one because I've heard really great things about that one, and so yeah. But the Shatter Me series, I just think it was not for me at the time, and now it's just too late. And I know there's like new books still coming out in that series, or maybe now they've all come out, I don't know. But I just, yeah, no, I don't think so. And another popular YA series, I think I'm just gonna start out with all the popular ones to just knock them off the park and alienate everyone, basically. Sorry. But that is the Throne of Glass series by Sarah J. Maas. So unlike Shatter Me, where I was like, eh, I don't really care about this anymore, or at all, Throne of Glass, I actively despise this series. I do not understand. I just don't get how people love this book series so much. And it's truly one of the books and series that I am, like, I think often even when I dislike something, I can see why other people enjoy it. But with Throne of Glass, in particular, I have such a hard time understanding why people love this book series so much. And my sister, I was talking to my sister a few months ago about it, and she really enjoyed it at the beginning and kind of like phased out of it. And she kind of was like, well, it's the first time that I saw, you know, cool fantasy things in a book, and that's why I liked it. And I can kind of see why that might be, why you might like it if you've never read fantasy before. Maybe, I don't know, I remember being so excited for this book series and for this idea of this character, Selena, who is like a prodigy assassin who is being hired by a king to do bad things and then maybe win her freedom, all of that fun stuff. So I was like, cool, I like this. This is like a concept that usually I would be so into, and I was so hyped for it. And then I read it and I just hated everyone so much. The only character I didn't hate in that first book, there's two characters. I didn't hate Kale and I didn't hate Nehemiah. Nehemiah, I think that's, I don't know how you pronounce her name. But those two characters were the only characters that I didn't hate. And spoilers, I hear that both of those characters don't really get treated well, yeah, in the rest of the series. And I despised Selena so much because she was like, Sarah J. Maas kept telling us how awesome and badass she is, and I just, like, in the, on paper, I'm like, this person is an idiot, I don't understand, you know? And yeah, so not a big fan of that series or any kind of fan, and I will not continue, and I highly doubt that I will ever read anything by Sarah J. Maas ever. But you know what, I'm very happy for all of you who enjoy it, and you know, she must be doing something right, because like those books keep coming out and keep selling like crazy and people love them, and so maybe I'm like, this is just a me thing, I don't know, but I truly, like, I'm baffled by it. But you know what, again, happy for everyone else who's enjoying these books, not for me. The next two series I have here are both fantasy, adult fantasy series. And the first one is The Way of Shadows, and I think the series is called, like, The Night Angel? Yeah, The Night Angel Trilogy. So I reviewed this, like, 3 or 4 years ago on here, and I talked about how this is a book series that's, like, kind of like the grimdark whatever genre, but I found that it kind of relied on unnecessary violence and tropes, and it just didn't really, it wasn't really doing anything interesting to me. And the violence in particular that I had such a huge issue with in this book is the way that sexual violence was used repeatedly for plot reasons and not explored in any meaningful way, in my opinion. And I think I also talked about, this has been such a long time, but I talked about the way that women are portrayed in this book as like being either the good woman or the tainted woman, and I just didn't love that. Anyways, I was much more generous, I think, in my review 5 years ago, or how, 4 years ago, I think it was 4 years ago, and I think I was like, oh, maybe I'll give it a chance and it's not that bad, but now I'm like, no, this book series is the worst, I don't like it. I tried to pick up the second book because I stupidly bought all three books of this series. I had a point like 4 years ago where I was like, I want to read all the assassin books, and I bought this one, and I also bought the Sarah J. Maas book, and both of them were such disappointments. But this one, I just am now, I'm like, why? I watched that video a while ago and I was like, I was holding back because I just don't understand the point of these books that are like just sad and dark and doesn't seem like there's any, like, why am I reading this? Who am I rooting for? I don't like any of the people. It just doesn't, you know, I don't like sad, dark, grim stuff for where there's no reason to keep going. And, you know, like, for example, I don't have a problem with dark books because I read the Game of Thrones books. I've read Joe Abercrombie. Both of those are very dark writers, dark fantasy, whatever. And I still do it. But in both of those cases, I feel like you have something to root for and to keep going with. And I didn't root for anyone in this book. Because even the, like, good characters were so flat, in my opinion. The series was also, you know, the one that kind of made me stop buying books in like multiple books in a series before I know for a fact that I will either like the author or the books. So anyways, last book series that I will for sure not be finishing is the Malazan Book of the Fallen series. This is Gardens of the Moon, and this is the only book in this video that I haven't actually finished, but I'm keeping it because I'm literally like less than 100 pages away from the end. And I've tried reading this book for over 2 years, and I just hate it so much because, again, I don't understand the point of this. And I've heard people talking about how it's like kind of like you have to push through and get to like book two or three or something like that before things start making sense. But this is one of those books where it feels like the emphasis is way too heavily on the world building and not so much on the characters, and to the point where I feel like the characters are basically just placeholders. And so it's very like I that's not the kind of book that I would enjoy. I need to care about the characters so that I can care what's happening to them, whereas in this book series it's like the characters are just there for like the author, and then like the god characters who are in this book, the other characters are just there for them to kind of like play chess with. And it's not even in a fun way, like, you know, you're kind of like rooting for the god characters or you're interested in them, because it doesn't really give you that much of a glimpse into those characters. And I don't understand the appeal of the series. Someone a while ago said that it's like Dungeons and Dragons inspired, and if you like D&D and that kind of role-playing games, you would enjoy this book. And maybe that's why I don't really like it, because I've never done that. But I just don't understand. Now we've come to the section of the video that I guess kind of I'm unsure about. I don't know if I need help per se, but like I would be willing to hear other people's suggestions about this part, which is book series that I don't know if I want to finish or if I'm just gonna like leave them to be. And yeah, so I actually only own one of these, and that series is the Queen of the Tierling series by Erica Johansson. I do know that this is kind of like a series that divides people, because some people love it and others hate it. And I don't know where I stand. So I loved Queen of the Tierling. I thought it was such a well-done series. I loved the main character and the way that she was written, how she's like, you know, this really powerful person who doesn't quite know what to do with her powers, and you know, it's like she has all this responsibility but hasn't really been given a chance to like form her own thoughts and opinions about things. And throughout the book we see her kind of make sense of all of that, and then there's the villain who is kind of a foil for the main character, and I think that's really interesting. And then in the second book, which is, god, I forget what it's called actually. I don't remember what the second book is called. I think the last one is The Fate of the Tierling, and then the second one, I don't know, something of the Tierling. Anyways, I was very of two minds about the second book. I liked where it was going with the whole storyline, but I thought that it kind of was, it was almost like reading two different books, and I can't get into what that means because it's spoilery. But part of that was intentional, you know, that it felt like you're reading two different books. And I liked each of those books, you know, separately. But then I don't know if I loved the way that it was blended together. And as I'm talking right now, I'm realizing that this series has a lot of similarities to the Imperium series, the Claire LeGrand series, the Fury Warren one, with the two timelines. And it's, yeah, interesting. Anyways, so I really loved this one. Loved each of the separate storylines in the second book, but didn't love how it was being tied together. And I've heard some things about the third book and how it ends. And I'm worried that that will throw me on the I hate this series kind of crowd. which is unfortunate because I really did really, really like this one. So, have you read this series and what do you think of the way that it ends? And do you think, based on what you know of me, that I would like it? I actually am, I don't know why I'm doing this. What I've read about the way that it ends makes me think that I will definitely not like it because it kind of uses some tropes that I don't love. But I'm also just curious and want to finish the series because I did really love this first one. So I don't know. I don't know. We'll see if I end up deciding to do it anyways. The next book series I have is The Drowning City, which is the first book of the Necromancer Chronicles by Amanda Downham, I think is her name. If it's wrong, I'm sorry. But I'll put a picture here somewhere. So I read this book like 4 years ago, and I really enjoyed it. It was a fresh fantasy setting. It was kind of set in this world that was very much inspired by some South Asian cultures, and I thought that was interesting. I thought that the author did a really great job being respectful but also kind of creative with the cultures that she was borrowing from. However, I have my thinking around that topic has evolved quite a bit. And so a part of me is worried if I go back now and read the rest of that series that I won't love the way that this white author, from what I understand, is using other cultures in her fantasy setting. So that's kind of the hesitation that I have with that series, and it's not a well-known series, so I don't think that anyone can tell me. I think I'm just gonna have to try it and see what I think. I did do a review of that book, either as part of a wrap-up or on its own. I'm gonna link down below whatever video it is. But I remember really enjoying it. I didn't love it, like it didn't blow my mind away, but I really, really enjoyed it. So anyways, that's kind of my concern, is like, have I changed enough as a reader where I can't enjoy that kind of book and where I'm gonna see more flaws in it than good things, or is it actually, does it hold up? And I guess I should tell you a bit more about the book. It follows this necromancer who is asked to come help this island with this issue that they're having, and then she comes and she finds out that there's a lot more going on than she was being told, and that there's people in the island who are actively working to make her job harder. I think this one also could probably fit in the whole like series that aren't series, because my understanding is like the first storyline is wrapped up and then she goes away and goes to a different place. And there's like some storyline threads that continue in the second and third book, but that it's like you don't have to, like, it's not closely connected. Again, I don't know because I haven't read the second and third book. And I don't know if I will, but I think for this one I'm curious enough to try it. And the next three series are all YA books that I don't know if I will finish, and I'm leaning towards that I probably will not finish. And the first one is a YA fantasy, Poison Study, by Maria V. Snyder. I read this like ages ago, and really, really loved what it was doing. In the first book, Poison Study, where we have this woman who is a criminal, and as another, it's one of those like, if in order to gain your freedom, you do this awful job, and then if you survive, you can be free. So her awful job is she has to be the poison tester for the king. And as she's doing that, she gets embroiled in all sorts of like world politics and magic things, and discovers that she's maybe like a part of this special group of people who has this special ability, and that's why she can survive being the poison person for the king. And there's a romance there, and there's a lot going on, and the first book was great. And then the second book, I really didn't love it. The second book was Magic Study, I believe. And I feel like in the second book, all the character development that we got from the first book, especially when it comes to the romantic relationship, kind of disappears, and like the characters get reduced to these weird like romancy stereotypes, and I don't love it. And I didn't really think that there was much growth with the main character, whose name I can't even remember at this point. So I don't know if I'll continue with that series. I think the third book is Fire Study, and I think there's also like a bunch of like offshoot series to that book series. But yeah, I don't know if I'll continue that one. We'll see. I also think that now that I've read a lot more different kinds of fantasy, and especially a lot more different kinds of YA fantasy, I don't know if I'll go back to that series and view it as positively as I did the first time. And this issue is the same issue that I have with the next two books. And the first one is The Raven Cycle, which the first book is The Raven Boys, I cannot remember the name of the author, but I will put her name or the book here. I read this book in 2015 and I liked it a lot, and it was like a really hyped book on BookTube at the time. I think the hype has now died down quite a bit, specifically also because of some things that the author has said and done, and especially with her another series of hers where she kind of, I think, appropriates some things. So that's not cool. I liked this book. I thought it was interesting. It was doing some unique stuff with like weird like folklore-y type magic, and I thought it was interesting. But it's the kind of book I think that you kind of need to read all of the books in quick succession, because there's a lot going on and like you're kind of confused the whole time you're reading almost, and then you kind of understand by the end. But I feel like it's been such a long time now that I haven't read the book, and in order to continue with the series I would have to reread The Raven Boys, and I honestly don't think I care enough about the series at this point to continue and to reread the Raven Boys. So I think I'm gonna have to just let this one go, but we'll see if I feel like picking it up again. I don't think so, but you let me know if you think that it's worth it and that I should, and there's like something that I would specifically be interested in. And then the last one, I don't even know why I put this one in this category, because I'm almost certain that I'm not gonna finish it. And that is the Uglies series by Scott Westerfield. I know, it's like blast from the past. This is like possibly one of the very first YA series to ever like be a big thing. I think I read this like so long ago, like I think almost 10 years ago now. And so there's Uglies, Pretties, and then I think Specials is the last book. And I read Uglies and I read Pretties and I loved them both. I thought they were really good and fun, and there was like some fun people. There was a lot of like really fun romance stuff going on. And yeah, so I really liked it at the time. But I think this is one of those series where I might have overgrown the series. I don't think there's anything wrong specifically with the book series, but it's dystopian YA and I feel like it'll feel very dated if I go back to it now. I might just do it because I'm a completionist and I don't like knowing that there's just like one book left that I could finish. I actually think there's like an offshoot series of this one too, but I don't count those as like part of the completion, whatever. So yeah, I don't know. We'll see. I feel like it's just I'm now so much older, and if I go back to it now, it'll just be like, this is not for me. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe we'll see. We will see. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know if any of the books that I mentioned here, whether in the I'm never gonna finish them category or the I might finish them category, that you think I absolutely have to finish. And for the first one, it's gonna be real hard to convince me to continue with those books, but if you make a compelling argument, I will do it. I will think about it. And then for the second one, I mean, part of why I did this is so that if there is a book series that you think I absolutely should finish in that second category that I'm not sure about, you can tell me, and then I will finish it, hopefully. Probably not anytime soon, because... Anyways, so thank you so much for watching, and the next video will be the book series that I absolutely am going to finish one day before I die, and also series that aren't really series. So, thanks so much for watching!